Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Make no mistake, the organized global crises are being accelerated right now. We're taking your phone calls. Coming up, FBI director warns of Khorasan attack here in the United States by the group you helped create, so we're going to break that down. But right now, let's go to Marty in Texas. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Hi, forever listener, first-time caller. Let me get right to the point. Are we not living in the script of V for Vendetta, except for the one important difference? At least there, they had the vaccine for their false flag pandemic outbreak already ready to go before the dictator was allowed to take power.
You're absolutely right, sir. I hadn't even thought about that since Darren McBreen made that great piece showing V for Vendetta and other films tied into the current Ebola outbreak. That's a great point.
And then next, and the real topic of my call was, what if anything can we do about it? Well, what I've done is to start a Facebook community page called Ban Ebola Flights Now. And what I'm doing is aggregating all the real stories from InfoWars, Health Ranger, and other sources, and calling for people to badger their senators and congressmen, not via email, but rather phone calls, overwhelm the Capitol switchboard and demand that these flights be banned, regardless of the poop that the CDC is spewing. And because they still care about the outcome and their fate from the upcoming midterm election, they may actually listen if enough people are screaming for it. And at least we can take that much of this matter into our own hands.
Well, very well said, Marty. Why do you and your gut think that they're obviously, there's no debating it, letting Ebola in, trying to spread it? I mean, that's just an absolute fact. How would they try to do that so openly, so arrogantly? What is wrong with them? Or do they know something I don't know?
I think that leads to the second point I wanted to discuss, and I'll try to do it very quickly. I'm sure you're familiar with the phenomenon psychologically of cognitive dissonance.
Yes.
Okay. Well, for those who don't, just quickly, it's people cannot believe that something that they have never experienced could possibly happen, especially when it goes against their belief system or their comfort.
That's right. America has been spared bad stuff for so long. We're like Native Americans that had never experienced smallpox. It wipes us all out. We have no immunity. We have no resistance.
Exactly. And so you take that to the point where, just like 9/11, our government couldn't possibly and wouldn't possibly do that. And if you believe that, you must be crazy. Same thing here. How could the government that's here to protect us, just do everything in their power to make sure that we are not only unprotected, but we're overtly exposed?
You know who I feel sorry for is the firefighters, the medical workers, and the police. They are going to be the ones, if this really breaks out, they're going to be wallowing in it. I mean, they are going to be getting it in record numbers just like they have in Africa. Well, I tell you, if I was an EMT or a cop right now, I'd be so angry.
Well, exactly.
Why do the Dallas police have to go track these people down and arrest them? It's not police job to go out and pick up people that have Ebola or may have Ebola. That's guys in hazmat suits.
Exactly.
I mean, this is really dangerous. This is really out of control.
Absolutely. And to think that the poor ambulance driver was not told for 48 hours that he had been a rolling typhoid Mary wagon. Are you serious?
And they didn't even clean it for days after that. Exactly. It's incredible. Oh, but don't worry. They've got face scanning sensors, in the schools now. It's just unbelievable. Thank you so much for the call. Great points. Alex, Donna, Tom, Eric, and others, your calls are coming up. But first, V for Vendetta, Ebola.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
I've always believed in nutrition and herbs. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Sourced from powerful organic herbs harvested around the planet and then concentrated for maximum potency.
I just received my Male Vitality about 3 days ago, and I must say, that is good stuff.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality and getting the day started.
It's not just the Super Male Vitality. All the products at InfoWarsLife.com are simply amazing. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
Using unparalleled research in the development of a synergistic formulation based around the key concepts of super oxygenation, the next level in cleansing is here. With key ingredients backed by real clinical studies, the new Oxy Powder, available through InfoWars Life, was invented during Dr. Group's research on the toxification of our bodies. Many herbal colon cleansers are harsh on the body and contain cheap and potentially dangerous ingredients, oftentimes full of synthetic fillers, GMOs, additives, or worse. Gently start cleaning your body with easy capsules that start working while you sleep. Oxy Powder does not require time off work, and there's no need for bad-tasting concoctions. Instead, Oxy Powder slowly releases monoatomic oxygen into the intestinal tract and body. Experience the astonishing cleansing power of superoxide and ozonide technology. Go to InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com to get started with Oxy Powder, or call 1-888-253-3139.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance. It's Alex Jones.
All right, Bill in Iowa is an EMT who says he's quitting in 2 weeks due to Ebola scare. Alex in Wisconsin says he works for a bio-cleaning company, wants to give his take on the protocols that are obviously being turned off. Before we do that, we aired this piece a few weeks ago, but Rob Dew and Darren McBreen that put it together expanded on it. Clips from 12 Monkeys, clips from V for Vendetta, tying it into real-world Marines training to kill zombies, Ebola outbreak news, to show how Hollywood now meets reality. And then we'll go straight to Bill and Alex, Eric, Tom, Donna's phone calls. But first, let's go to this piece.
Well, it sounds like the perfect script for a horror movie. A virus with no vaccine and no cure kills thousands of people.
5 billion people died in 1996 and 1997. Almost the entire population of the world. Only about 1% of us survived.
We'll report reports of flu cases along the border, but officials are saying they aren't connected.
Surely there's very real and very convincing data that the planet cannot survive the excesses of the human race.
And I actually think the world will be much better when there's only 10 or 20% of us left. Dr. Eric Bianca.
But most frightening was the fact that in a crowd of over 1,000 prominent scientists, local newspapers reported that 95% of those in attendance gave Bianca sustained standing ovations every time he extolled the virtues of mass-culling microbes and man's destruction, and went on to laud the virtues of Ebola because it would kill 90% of the world population quickly.
The World Health Organization said on Tuesday the Ebola death toll jumped by almost 200 in a single day to at least 2,296 and is likely to be higher than that.
The head of the U.S. Centers for Disease Control confirmed Tuesday that West Africa is in a desperate situation, but that there is still hope that the outbreak can be reined in.
A top German virologist has caused shockwaves by asserting that it's too late to halt the spread of the Ebola virus.
In other news, the CDC is receiving reports of a possible flu outbreak in San Francisco.
If the symptoms were first detected in Philadelphia on December 27, 1996, that makes us know that
it was released in Philadelphia probably on December 13, 1996.
And was seen sequentially after that in
San Francisco, New Orleans, Rio de Janeiro, Rome, Kinshasa, Karachi, Bangkok, then Peking.
This is some trip you're taking, sir. Is this all in 1 week?
Business.
One of the two Americans infected with the Ebola virus has arrived in Atlanta from Africa for treatment.
The Massachusetts doctor arrived at the Nebraska Medical Center just before dawn this morning to be treated for Ebola.
And right now, his or her blood sample is on its way to the Centers for Disease Control.
The new ability to wage war is born from the blood of its victims.
There you see. Also invisible to the naked eye. It doesn't even have an odor.
This Ebola outbreak is unprecedented and has become the deadliest on record.
Ebola is now an epidemic.
You start to get a sense of the rapid escalation now we're seeing of the virus.
Imagine a virus, the most terrifying virus you can, and then imagine that you and you alone have the cure.
Without specific drugs or a vaccine for Ebola, the only thing doctors can do for those suffering from this disease is treat their symptoms.
Ebola is not spread through the air like the flu.
One will not likely catch the virus just by nearing someone who has it.
In 1989, Ebola made its way to the U.S. This new strain of Ebola had shown the potential to spread through the air.
They are now calling this a true pandemic. 5 years on.
Still no cure.
No cure.
The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation has given £31 million to help battle the Ebola epidemic in Africa. It is hoped it will also speed up the development of drugs and vaccines, as Ebola has killed more than half of its 4,300 victims.
First, we've got population. Now, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, health care, we could lower that by perhaps 10 or 15%.
A preventative vaccine for the Ebola virus could be available as early as next year, as British pharma company GlaxoSmithKline.
So you want to balance the need to get a potentially effective vaccine to the people who need it in a way that you can get some meaningful information as to A, whether it does work or not, and whether it does harm.
A confidential GlaxoSmithKline document recently leaked to the press exposed that within a 2-year period, a total of 36 infants died after receiving the 6-in-1 vaccine of Inferix Hexa.
UK pharmaceutical giant GlaxoSmithKline will plead guilty and pay a record-breaking $3 billion to settle the largest case of healthcare fraud in US history.
I'm going right out to get vaccinated.
The vaccine uses a modified chimpanzee common cold virus to carry a single Ebola protein.
We're ready to move on to the next phase.
Does it work like we predicted?
With one exception.
Can't dawdle on this one. We have to move with force and make sure that we are catching this as best we can.
Nearly 2,500 people have died.
Thousands more have been infected. Amid an international call for action, President Obama announced America's plan,
which will see three